must have weighed 4¼ pounds.
Did you hear that?
This thing was at least a 105 howitzer.
Gene Shepard.
I never saw anything like it. I sort of scrunched back.
Let me turn it down. Midnights to 3, I listen to a bunch of radio shows. Download the podcasts and listen to them. I have a regular schedule. From 1 to 2, it's the Gene Shepard. It's an old Gene Shepard show. I want to be on the... In my head, and I know this sounds ridiculous for a 41-year-old man, I am playing radio. I'm pretending like this is the midnight schedule of my own radio station up in Williams. And at midnight, it's the CBS Roundup News, followed by the Osgood File, then the Tim and Willie radio podcast, put in some music to fill out the hour, then it's CNN News, Osgood, music, and Gene Shepard. And then after that, it's news, the ABC News podcast, and some songs until I go to bed until 3. Yes. Yes. I am a dweeb. Welcome to the show.
Hi, I'm Eric Paul Johnson, creative genius. I say creative genius with some self-mocking, some pride, and some truth. I'm a cartoonist. Here's my book of tunes. It's pretty thick. You should buy it. I'm a writer. Here's a little book I put out of short stories and comic strips I've written. You should buy it. I'm a musician. And video maker. I've been drawing tunes since April 1977, when I was a month away from turning 8 years old. Been writing all my life. Books, school newspaper, did my own satire newspaper from 1983 to 2000. I've recorded a mess of songs since 1981. Although, honestly, I'm not the smoothest of musicians. I can pass. Barely. And in October last year, I got into making videos. It's fun. Except for tuning, it seems to combine all the things I do. I love writing and playing with images and sound. I love doing all the creative things I do. My creativity has been a constant companion that's rarely let me down. And I have no doubt whatsoever, it has literally saved my life countless times. I have all kinds of cool stuff. Old radios, lots of Legos, a life-size latex Yoda. But my creativity is the thing I love the most. Did I just jump to the first question? We just covered that. Right now, my biggest fear is losing my apartment. My unemployment benefits ran out, and I still can't find a job. I have $200 to my name, with $1,100 worth of bills about to plow into me in the next week. I have a couple ideas, though, if it turns out I don't have enough money. One, beg my brains out with management not to kick me out. The other plans are less humiliating. When I open my door, I find TV cameras, balloons, and an oversized novelty check from Publishers Clearinghouse. Or I win the lottery tonight. Hey, that'd be a great way to end this video. I call my other plan the final solution. I strap explosives around my waist, go to the office, and demand they let me stay or I blow up the complex with everyone in it. Well, maybe not. I've never handled explosives, and the only thing I've ever wired up are the speakers to my stereo. I can already see how that would end before I finish thinking about it. Okay, I get the red wire attached to the top of the dynamite, and the blue wire attached to the bottom of the dynamite. Once you have successfully attached the blue wire to the top of the dynamite and the red wire to the bottom of the dynamite, next... Wait. What? For lunch today, I'm having bologna. Not a bologna sandwich, just bologna. Being unemployed, out of unemployment benefits, and waiting for food stamps, I can't afford exotic, extravagant luxury items like bread. So I'm having bologna. I do have mustard, though, so it's not a total loss. The Republicans who say people living off of unemployment are spoiled and living the good life are friggin' morons! While I have my bologna and mustard, take this opportunity to have some bologna yourself. And take this culinary tip from me. Try it between two pieces of bread. It'll taste better. Your fingers won't get greasy, and it's more filling. Enjoy! Oh, nerds.
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Delicious things to eat.
The popcorn can't be beat.
The sparkling drinks are just dandy. The chocolate bars and the candy. So let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
From around 2:30 to 5, I nap. I have raging insomnia. So I nap to make up for all the sleep I lost the night before. I still have insomnia even when I don't nap. I enjoy a good nap. Keeps me looking young, fresh, and well-preserved. Like a baggie of strawberries in the back of the refrigerator, or Lenin in his Tupperware tomb. In an attempt to make the Phoenix summers a tad less of a brutal, horrific, torturous hell, I watch a Marx Brothers movie every Saturday night over the summer. They made enough to watch every Saturday from the first Saturday in June to the last Saturday of August. You're saying, what? Stay at home on a Saturday night and watch an old movie by yourself? Why don't you go out? Well, first of all, I don't have a car. Second, most of my friends are married or involved in a romantic relationship, so they're all out having fun with each other. Unless you're a crispy vanilla cookie layered with peanut butter and covered in a chocolate coating, nobody likes a tag-along. I watch the movies in order, so tonight, it's Room Service. It's Phoenix, it's summer, I'm by myself. Let's just say I don't have any pockets right now and leave it there. It happened! I won the lottery! I won the Powerball! I am the new owner of $73 million! I'm gonna buy a car, I'm gonna get a DeLorean, and I'm gonna Back to the Futurize it. It's gonna be so wicked cool. I'll get a house in Flagstaff and... Food! I'm gonna get food! Bread! I'm gonna get bread. Oh my god. I'm filthy rich. I'm gonna go crazy. I'm gonna get rye bread. It's nice rye bread. Oh, that'd be so great. Oh, I'm full of crap. Of course I didn't win. It's the lottery. Nobody wins. So, I've watched a Saturday Night Live rerun I've seen 3 times, and now it's midnight. Sunday, July 25th, 2010. Now I answer email and listen to the weekend midnight schedule. CNN radio news, Obama's radio address, an old radio show from the 30s to 50s, fill the hour with music, and at 1, news and Gene Shepherd, and I go to bed and attempt to sleep at 3 o'clock. And there you go. There's a full Saturday for Eric Paul Johnson. Seriously, how do you get a life?